What's the astronomy of the U.S. dollar now, the bigger, the vision picture of this dominant currency?
Well, I think a lot of people are at a turning point. You know, a lot of people after many years, several years of a dollar rally from 2014 through 2016, dollar fell out of bed last year, began off this year on a softer tone. And I think people have given up on the bullish dollar view. And I think that's just when it comes back. For me, the key level to watch is 126 in the euro.
The other thing you're watching, which surprises me, and I want you to explain this, and you didn't say this just because Lisa's on set today, is as a currency guy, you're watching the 2s-10 spread. Why does the yield curve and the new flatter curve, bring up the chart, Jamila, if you would. Here's the chart we showed earlier, like 10 minutes ago. Here's the same chart. Why is a foreign exchange guy looking at the 2s-10 spread?
Well, first, I'd say that the San Francisco Fed recently did a newsletter talking about how valid that yield curve still is when a lot of people are trying to play down its significance. Secondly, it looks to me like the U.S. economy is showing a lot of symptoms of being late cycle. And so we're looking at the yield curve as another one of these indicators that tell us that maybe the U.S. economy has seen the better days of this economic expansion. I'm looking for a downturn maybe late next year, early 2020, with this fiscal stimulus that we're getting from the White House, giving us a little bit of late cycle expansion, but nothing that changes the game plan, really.
Neil Dutta, who was on in the earlier hours, said that until the yield curve is flat, he doesn't care. Do you agree?
Well, yeah, in some ways, it's true that the yield curve is not inverted yet, and the significance is really when it comes inverted. But people like myself have to look not just where we are today, but anticipate where we're going to be. Federal Reserve is going to hike rates at least two more times this year. And I think that's the risk is that we're headed towards a flattening yield curve.
Yeah.
We're trying to project what's going to happen, not just this year or this week, but 2019, 2020.